Hi guys, it's Tiffany here, and today I will be doing a class presentation for ENT645 Entrepreneurial Marketing at Western Carolina University. So for today's content, I will be discussing a story found online by author Philip Imabwali, and it's called A Day in the Life Without Blacks. So this is a story of a little boy named Theo, who woke up one morning and asked his mother, "Mom, what if there were no black people in the world?" Well, his mother thought about that for a moment, and then said, "Son, follow me around today, and let's just see what it would be like if there were no black people in the world." Mom said, "Now go get dressed, and we will get started." Theo ran to his room to put on his clothes and shoes. His mother took one look at him and said, "Theo, where are your shoes? And those clothes are all wrinkled. I must iron them." However, when she reached for the ironing board, it was no longer there. You see, Sarah Boone, a black woman, invented improvements to the ironing board. And Jan E. Matzlinger, a black man, invented the shoe lasting machine. "Oh well," she said, "please go and do something to your hair." Theo ran in his room to comb his hair, but the comb was not there. You see, Walter Sammons, a black man, invented the hot comb. Theo decided to just brush his hair, but the brush was gone as well. You see, Lydia O. Newman, a black female, invented a brush containing synthetic bristles. Well, this was a sight. No shoes, wrinkled clothes, hair a mess, even mom's hair without the hair care inventions of Madam C.J. Walker. Well, you get the picture. Mom told Theo, "Let's do our chores around the house and then take a trip to the grocery store." Theo's job was to sweep the floor. He swept and he swept and he swept. When he reached for the dustpan, it was not there. You see, Lloyd P. Ray, a black man, invented improvements to the dustpan. So he swept his pile of dirt over in the corner and left it there. He then decided to mop the floor, but the mop was gone as well. You see, Thomas W. Stewart, a black man, invented a clamping device that could wring out water by using a lever. Theo yelled to his mom, "Mom, I'm not having any luck." "Well, son," she said, "let me finish washing these clothes and we will prepare a list for the grocery store." When the wash finished, she went to place the clothes in the dryer, but it was not there. You see, George T. Sampson, a black man, invented the clothes dryer. Mom asked Theo to go get a pencil and some paper to prepare their list for the market. So Theo ran for the paper and pencil, but noticed the pencil lead was broken. Well, he was out of luck, because John T. Love, a black man, invented the portable pencil sharpener. Mom reached for a pen, but it was not there, because William Purvis, a black man, invented the improvements to the fountain pen. As a matter of fact, Lee Burridge invented the improvements to the typewriting machine, adding movement and simplifying parts. And W.A. Lovett, he invented the advanced printing press. Theo and his mother decided just to head out to the market. Well, then Theo opened the door. He noticed the grass was as high as he was tall. You see, John Burr, a black man, invented one of the first rotary blade lawnmowers. They made their way over to the car and found that it just wouldn't go. You see, Richard Spikes, a black man, invented the automatic gear shift, and Joseph Gamble invented the supercharger system for internal combustion engines. They also noticed that the few cars that were moving were running into each other and having wrecks because there were no traffic signals. You see, Garrett A. Morgan, a black man, invented the three-position traffic signal. Well, it was getting late, so they walked to the market, got their groceries, and returned home. Just when they were about to put away the milk, eggs, and butter, they noticed the refrigerator was gone. You see, John Standard, a black man, invented improvements to the refrigerator, so they just left the food on the counter. By this time, Theo noticed he was getting mighty cold. Mom went to turn up the heat, and what do you know? Alice Parker, a black female, patented the system of central heating using natural gas. Even in the summertime, they would have been out of luck, because Frederick Jones, a black man, designed and patented various air conditioning units. It was almost time for Theo's father to arrive home. He usually takes the bus, but there was no bus, because its precursor was the electric trolley, refined and patented by another black man, Elbert R. Robinson. He usually takes the elevator from his office on the 20th floor, but there was no elevator, because Alexander Miles, a black man, invented the design for automatically opening and closing doors on the elevator. He also usually dropped off the office mail at a nearby mailbox, but it was no longer there, because Philip Downing, a black man, patented the modern-day letterbox, and William Barry invented the postmarking and canceling machine. Theo and his mother sat at the kitchen table with their heads in their hands. When the father arrived, he asked, "Why are you sitting in the dark?" "Why?" Because Lewis Howard Latimer, a black man, patented the use of a carbon filament, which made possible the widespread use of electric light. Theo quickly learned more about what it would be like if there were no black people in the world, especially if he were ever sick and needed blood. Dr. Charles Drew, a black scientist, found a way to better preserve and store blood, and later developed large-scale blood banks in early World War II. Well, what if a family member had to have heart surgery? This would not have been possible without Dr. Daniel Hale Williams, a black doctor who performed the first documented open heart surgery. So if you ever wondered, like Theo, where would we be without black people? Well, it's pretty plain to see. We'd still be in the dark. I hope that you enjoyed this presentation, and I hope that no matter how big or small your contribution to the world, that you realize we're all in this together. While many of these inventions were created by whites and blacks, many of the improvements fashioned then are still utilized today. So realize your dream, commit to your struggle, and persevere to bring your dreams to fruition just as these individuals have. Thanks for joining me today.